on Albert Square.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Christmas is here.
One big happy family
bringing good cheer.
What? She's been taking you for a ride for months.
And for Mick Carter, it's time to say goodbye.
I just wanted a nice day. My final Christmas in the Vic with my family.
So let's make it a special one, hey?
Where is it?
EastEnders, Christmas Day on BBC iPlayer.
Wow, sounds good. Gabby in for Scott Mills after the news. Then it's Sarah, then Joe, then a top brass Christmas with James Morrison and Trevor Nelson at 10, Phil Williams at midnight. BBC Radio 2, thanks for being with us. Sounds app, smart speaker and 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Claire Runacres. The boss of the NHS Confederation has warned the government about the level of harm and risk to patients faced during ambulance strikes in part of England and Wales tomorrow. In a letter to the Prime Minister, Matthew Taylor said NHS leaders couldn't guarantee patient safety. Mr. Taylor urged the government to reach a compromise for the sake of patients. Oops, excuse me a moment, I seem to be having a few problems with my computer. Let's try this.
We are worried about the risks tomorrow, but, you know, with the possibility of further strikes developing as winter unfolds, that's why our leaders have come to us and said to us, look, you know, we need to make clear that we are entering into a very dangerous time. And this is why we are upping even more our call to the government and to the trade unions to try to find a way of resolving this dispute.
Thousands of nurses in England, Wales and Northern Ireland are staging a second day of strike action about pay. The Royal College of Nursing says below inflation increases are compromising care by making it harder to attract and retain nurses. The government says the union's demand for a 19% increase is unaffordable and would take money away from frontline services. These nurses on a picket line in Liverpool said wages and conditions were falling behind.
It's not just about pay, it's about the working conditions. Pay is a part of it, but we're also, what we're protesting for is safe staffing levels.
I find now that I'm having to work overtime just to make ends meet, and it's really difficult.
I just think that argument of there is no money, there is no money, there is no magic money trick is a joke.
Train drivers from 15 rail companies will stage another strike on the 5th of January as part of a long-running row about pay. It'll add to major rail disruption in the first week of the new year, with the RMT union already planning strikes on the 2 days either side. The rail delivery group said it wanted to work with the ASLEF union to end the dispute. A former secretary who worked for the commander of a Nazi concentration camp has been convicted of complicity in the murders of more than 10,000 people. Irmgard Fürchner, who's 97, was given a 2-year suspended jail sentence. Hundreds of thousands of people are lining the streets of Buenos Aires for an open-top bus parade by Argentina's World Cup winning team. The squad arrived home from Qatar earlier, with mass celebrations taking place outside the airport as the players landed. The government there has declared a national holiday after Lionel Messi led his team to a thrilling victory over France. And the Charlatans and Primal Scream keyboardist Martin Duffy has died at the age of 55. He suffered a brain injury after a fall and died peacefully surrounded by his family. The Charlatans frontman Tim Burgess paid tribute to his former bandmate, saying his death was a tragic loss of a beautiful soul. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past two.
Thank you very much, Bobby.
Now, Gabby Roslin. Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
Or will be explained why I'm here in a moment.
I didn't ask for a free ride. I only asked you to show me a real good